Friends, India's growth story is not only good for the people of India, but also for the entire world. We live in an increasingly connected world. As the third largest economy, our growth and prosperity will inevitably contribute to global growth and development. We are committed to make a peaceful, stable, and economically interlinked world. India, as a responsible member of the international community, has also been in the forefront of our collective fight against climate change. Despite having a historically low carbon footprint, India has been playing an active role in the global fight against climate change. At the domestic level, this has been done by unveiling our national action plan to reduce carbon emissions, increase forest cover, and replacing traditional carbon fuels with renewable energy supplies. On the international plane, we have partnered with like-minded countries to launch the International Solar Alliance, which aims to harness the clean and unlimited solar energy as an alternative to fossil fuels. We are one of the largest troop contributing countries for UN peacekeeping operations, and we are proud to have been able to contribute the peace on the Korean Peninsula. We have extended a helping hand to countries in need and participated actively in humanitarian work and disaster relief. We have carried out operations in conflict zones and rescued not only Indians, but also nationals of many other countries. We have been an active and considerate development partner for other developing countries, with our guiding principle being to help in developing their physical and social infrastructure. Through these efforts, we seek to ensure that the benefits of a globalized and interconnected world are equally experienced by all. Over the past 2 years, my government has renewed interaction and forged new partnership across continents. In the East Asian context, we have redefined our engagements with countries in the region, including with the Republic of Korea under our Act East policy. I am glad to hear an echo of our approach in President Moon's new Southern policy,